The big story around this perception corruption index is big money, big politics, and political party. Big money, individuals, wealthy people being in charge of electoral campaigns and political parties. That's what the Transparency International report says is a big issue for many countries around the world, Nigeria not excluded. So let's get a bit of a sense of this. Let's get a first word on this and raise the curtain on what is going to be a very major conversation, not just on this program, but throughout the day, tomorrow, and continuing with Johnson Chukwu, who is the CEO at Cowry Asset Management. Johnson is joining us via Skype from downtown Lagos. So let's have your first word or your initial thoughts on this, Johnson, when it comes to the highlight of this report, which is politics, money, and corruption. This, what you called the unholy trinity.
Boston, thank you for having me. And when I saw the complex relationship between politics, money, and campaign funding, I was quite excited because Nigeria is one of the classical examples of where too much money is corrupting the political system. I mean, we just came out of an election last year, and you bear witness with me that the impact of excessive campaign funding, the impact of people donating billions to political parties had some negative impact on the outcome of the election. Not only that, the performance of elected officials when they are captured by money bags is always so bad. And it's difficult for anybody who is brought into a political office to resist the directives of the funding partner or the godfather, as we call it in Nigeria. And that clearly makes it difficult for such elected officials to enforce anti-corruption policies. So you actually, a living witness of instances where excessive campaign funding or impact of excess money or big money having negative impact on the political system and anti-corruption war.
Mm. This report highlights, as you have seen, that says countries that perform well on the corruption perception index have strong enforcement of campaign finance regulations. Do we have campaign finance regulations in Nigeria? If yes, how strong is it? If no, why do you think we can enthrone it?
Yes, both we do have campaign funding. The Electoral Act is very clear on campaign funding restrictions. For instance, the Electoral Act specified that a presidential candidate cannot spend more than 5 billion naira for a campaign, for a national election campaign. A national assembly member cannot spend more than 70 million naira for a campaign. And the Electoral Act also specifies that no individual or entity can contribute to a candidate or a political party an amount more than 1 million naira. But unfortunately, that is not being enforced. So the problem we have is the issue of enforcement. I mean, the regulation, the law requires that any donation made to a political party is reported to INEC. And INEC will have a record of all donations and individual donations. And any amount of donation above 100,000 naira must be reported with the individual. And if the political party accepts a donation above 100,000 naira without specifying the individual donor, then that political party and its operating will prosecute it. Unfortunately, none of that, this has ever happened in this country. So what we have is a law that's observed in abeyance. And because any law that is not enforced is always disregarded. So the campaign regulations or funding regulations are not being obeyed. I mean, you will agree with me that there's no party that spends less than 5 billion naira. I mean, no president can spend less than 5 billion naira in the election. And there's no national assembly member that spent less than 70 million naira in the election. So who has been charged to court? Who has been prosecuted? Who has been convicted? Who has been jailed? As to serve a deterrent or to other people? And interestingly, like I said earlier, if people fund candidates wholly, and when they should normally not spend more than 1 million naira on the candidate, then what you have is a political capture, so that the elected official becomes subservient to the person who funded him or her, and it cannot take any action that will injure the interests of such a godfather. Not only that, the godfather becomes a lord and lives above the law.
Johnson, a quick one here. If you look at the United States, as we speak in the jostling for the 2020 presidential election, money is big and you need big money. Donald Trump, President Trump, is getting campaign funding. Bloomberg, Michael Bloomberg, is a multi-billionaire. And of course, if you look at the Democrats and others, they also, Elizabeth Warren and the rest, they are all talking about millions of dollars in campaign funding. So politics is big money. Big money is politics. You don't go there if you don't have money. I guess we lost Johnson Chukwu there. It's a big story about politics, money, and corruption. And of course, political desk and political shows today will drill down a lot more on these very important highlights of the 2019 Corruption Perception Index. You don't want to miss our lineup for today on Channels Television on this important report highlighting the corrupting influence of big money, wealthy individuals, governments who are unable to control or enforce political funding, and how electoral monies is a big problem for corruption around the world, and Nigeria not excluded.